Welcome to the third video of my three-part video series about messenger marketing and my upcoming program Bot Mastery 2.0. I'm so excited about this. Things have been very intense in the last week. Thank you for all the comments and PMs that I'm getting. And the waiting list, the early bird waiting list has been growing so much. I couldn't even expect that much of a growth. So I suggest if you're not on the list yet, just make sure you get your name and email address on the list, because at this point, I don't even think that it would be possible to get on the to secure a spot for you if you're not in this list. So just make sure you comment below, click on the links, and put your name and email address on this list. In the last two videos, I showed you what's possible with messenger marketing. I showed you some of the results that people are getting right now. And I also showed you how powerful templates can be, so you can save your time, leverage these templates, and still bring the same results for your clients. And also, you know how important it is to have your own chatbot for your agency. In this video, I'm going to show you the chatbot agency blueprint. I'm going to show you exactly how you can go from having zero or little experience with bots to becoming someone who can build them effortlessly and with little time involved, and also charge for this valuable skill set. So I'm going to share the exact process with you, and I'm also going to talk about my upcoming masterclass, Bot Mastery 2.0. So without further ado, welcome to the Chatbot Agency Blueprint. So what I want to talk about is the Chatbot Agency Blueprint, and this is my approach to it. It's about being close to the market and being practical about things and not trying to develop theories or skill sets that won't be needed. So what I like to start is having an agency chatbot so you can use it for demo purposes. Then when the people are interested, you are able to make a sale, and then you create a chatbot and deliver for your clients. Now, with my support, it's completely possible that you get to this point without having a comprehensive understanding of everything. But you can still deliver a very good chatbot, which you can later optimize and improve, and also have the clients to grow it and make it a successful long-term relationship between you and your client. So let's go into some of the details and also what I'm covering in Bot Mastery 2.0. So your agency chatbot, and your agency chatbot is supposed to be for showcase, for demo purposes. So this is one of the most important thing, especially when you start out with chatbots, because it's easier to show than to tell, and it also gives you credibility. So let me just put it here as well. So you have the credibility as you demonstrate it from your page, that's your agency, and the client can see, okay, who this is very interesting. So one of the things that you can count on is that the client will think about how it can help them as well. So you can very good showcase and see what they are interested in, see how it can help them. So that way you can also learn from it and prepare your pitch according to it and see what would be helpful for the client itself. Don't forget that your agency chatbot is going to collect data that you can later reuse and do some sort of content marketing. So even if people don't buy at the first point, you have multiple points for them. So if you connect with them via the phone or personally or email, ads, whatever, you have different touch points, and your chatbot is one of them. And it's very good that you can showcase your product, your service inside a list that you build. So you have all these people who are highly interested in your services, or at least you're just building up this connection. And you can content marketing then, you can use content marketing to get back to them. So this could be something like a new thing coming up, like WhatsApp is opening and they're like, oh no, I'm interested, let's talk. So you can either personally reach out because you see that they they were interested, so you can have some sort of a reach out here. And it can be automatic by the bot, or because it's a schedule, like, hey, we haven't chatted for a while. Or you can have manually, as you see the conversations, and you can have them schedule a call right inside of the messenger. And let me just tell you, like, some of the people are impressed by how this can go smoothly inside of messenger, the scheduling process. And this can also showcase again credibility or extra functions you can sell to them later. Okay, so I think it's really important that you start from that point, because you're closer to the market right from the get-go. And once you have a couple of people who are interested, you need to sell them the chatbot. So when it comes to sales, it's really important that you have the right mindset. So we're actually going to discuss this quite a bit in Bot Mastery 2.0. And it's also important that you understand how you can showcase and sell them the value of the chatbot, and not what you think the chatbot is necessarily. So it's basically benefits for them, and not features, not something that you think it could be good. So it's really important how to communicate these benefits to them. And it's really important that we discuss the fine details between retainers and one-time fee. So here is it. I'm going to discuss in the course more in depth how you can make sure that you manage to get them on a retainer. So that's an ongoing fee, and you get money from that on an ongoing basis on every month. And we are going to talk about, I'm going to offer like a template for the sales, so you can have it template. And actually, before the template, it's also worth to note that you kind of want to demonstrate your authority on this topic. And again, it goes back to credibility. So you want to showcase them how a chatbot can help, and talk about strategy. So the more personalized it is, the better it will help your sales process. So we'll dive into strategy as well and see how it can help them achieve their goals. And you have to frame this as an investment for them. So they will basically see it not as a cost, but an investment with the corresponding strategy that can make them more money. And that should be the whole reason here as well. So you can make them more on back on their investment. So it's a big ROI investment on their side, and should be a no-brainer offer at the end. Okay, so let's talk about creating the chatbots for the client. And this is where you really have to go deeper into chatbots and learn more about them in terms of how to do like different tools. So we will cover tools for that. And tools, I'm not only meaning bot builders, but that's a big topic. So you actually don't need to learn all the bot builders out there. I know a few, but you don't need to. It's completely enough if you know one really well. And there are design tools such as the one I'm using right now to help the client communication and design the chatbot. And there are also integrators or like third-party tools that come into play when you go with chatbots. I just like create an extra like other tools category. I think about like Genesis when you connect your chatbot builder with AI and Slack. Zapier or Integromat and other tools as well. We will cover these, what's needed. And if we go over, next point could be how you talk about the conversational design. So you need to design the conversations, and there are different things that come into play. So conversational design. And what we want to do here is think about psychological principles. And also what Messenger does, what are the differences between certain elements, so messaging elements and design elements that you can use. So sometimes it makes sense to go that way, sometimes to which buttons, multimedia and so on. And the whole thing is helped by different templates and flows. So what you want to do after a while is to create your own templates as well, but I supplied some of them, and this can help utilize all this and have the tools. I a little bit run out of for in advanced so because I wanted to cover some of the things that you can do with the chatbot, and I'm going to show this detailed in screen share videos, how to create segments, how to create broadcasts and how to optimize them, how to go with sequences, for example. And also many of the topics or the options that these bot builders and tools offer us. So we'll cover everything that could be needed and could make your chatbot more powerful, including some of the advanced integrations and also NLP. Just put it that way. So making the bot smarter in that regard, using Google's AI and Dialogflow. And once you have that and you built a great chatbot to your clients and have all these elements and you can just optimize with the flows, and we're talking about testing and delivery. And there are some of my tips here that can really help this whole process. So you don't have to like stress about it and how to deliver, or having the issues of having things on the client's account and live and things don't go well. I had my fair share of learning in this topic, so I think I can contribute to that as well. You just want to make sure that everything works fine and don't run into issues, or not like the clients or the prospects of the clients get back some of the issues that you have. So this is basically what can help you, and this is very massive in bot mastery when we go into details about the differences between the conversational design elements, or just like how to optimize and go with the segments, sequences and many other tools that we have. And I suggest to have like the first version of the bot as soon as possible, because it already starts working. So what you can do is, and for the whole chatbot agency blueprint is applicable, is that you can go back and optimize later on for different stages. So not just monitoring, but once you have a better template or you learn more about some advanced integrations, you can go back to the chatbot agency, your agency chatbot, and improve things here. You understand more about strategy, you can sell better, and on so on. So basically it's not a rigid formula, it's just helping you to have an overview and also improve and optimize all the way down. So I'm going to cover some of the pitfalls when it comes to monitoring your chatbot and putting it out there, and the live way of chatbots, basically when they go live and things come up and issues come up. And also, like, we are going to cover A-B tests, what to measure, how to optimize, and all these topics. And it's super important because it's not just like set and done for one. You want to tweak it all the time and have better conversion rates and optimize it so people enjoy it more and it brings more value to the business, brings you money, higher satisfaction, better customer support, and so on. And the final point about the chatbot agency blueprint is the growing of the chatbot list. And basically we will cover, and you should know about the different methods, such as, for example, the comment method. I have a big guide on that. I actually wrote it almost exactly 2 years ago. cover Facebook ads. Messenger has a very good way to integrate with Facebook ads. You can create audiences right away from your chatbot, and that way you can just like save so much information and get really, really point on with the targeting. We'll cover website integrations or website opt-ins, let's put it that way. So talking about the live chat or some sort of pop-ups or slide-ins, widgets, and also other tools. And I cannot emphasize enough that how important it is that you reflect on the strategy on this part as well. So we just like put this here as well. Maybe I will color it as well a little bit so it stands out a little bit more. So all your growth should be surrounded about the strategy, about the business, and seeing what their strengths. Is there any other factors that make the decisions on how to grow, how to optimize the whole flow? And this is where you really want to repeat all this cycle from again, and like go with the new sales cycle, have more clients, understand them better, learn more about chatbots, improve them, maybe do other tools so you can understand other things better, optimize, learn from them, look at the data, have conversations with the people, and just grow your list, and then go back to broadcasts and learn from these data, optimize, learn more about how you can get people into this. And this is just a never-ending cycle, really. And yeah, so that's basically what I do in my own agency. This is what I teach in my course and what I suggest to everyone having a chatbot agency and who wants to make money with chatbots and selling them to clients. I hope you enjoyed the chatbot agency blueprint, and it's been a crazy week, and thank you for watching this video. And I'm also excited about opening Bot Mastery 2.0. I'm going to send the link this Sunday, open the cart on Sunday, for the people who are on the early bird list, and then open it to on Monday to the public. So let me just give you some instructions on how you can secure your spot. So if you're on the early bird list, you will get a registration link at 10 a.m. Pacific time on Sunday. And you can go there and register and join the course. And after that, it will be also available to the public. And now I have on my Facebook group, email list, messenger list, YouTube channel. So I have like 10,000 people who can potentially join the course. And of course, I don't want to deal with so many people. I want to keep the quality high. And also, I'm the one answering questions in the mastermind group and doing the weekly coaching calls. So initially, I wanted to limit the number of new people joining the course around 10 and 20 people. But now with the insane growth, I'm considering about 50 people. So make sure your name and email is on the early bird waiting list. And also on Sunday at 10 a.m. Pacific time, I'm going to send out the early bird registration link. So make sure you are in the email inbox and find that email by refreshing different folders. It will be there and it will have the early bird registration link. So you just click on the link and you can secure your spot there. And if you put it off until Monday or Tuesday, I'm not sure, I cannot guarantee that you will have one of these spots. And I missed out opportunities in the past actually, so I just want to make sure that you're on the list and you also are ready on Sunday to open your email and secure your spot. And I'm super excited for the people who will join and become a new student, and we can start work together and achieving your goals together. Thank you for watching all these videos, and I'm super excited to see you on the other side.